Hello, in this demo, I am going to deal with form view control. What is a form view control? Form view control is a control on which I can have a single record as a single form. Like grid view is replica of your data table. Form view is nothing but it shows each record on each page. Grid view is showing 10 records on a single page or 20 records on a single page, as I said. Whereas form view will show each record on a single page in the form of a form. Now just we'll go to the toolbox, data controls. I'll take form view, I'll drag and drop it here. Now I need to configure my form view. I'll select new data source, database, okay. And I'll select the connection string, I'll say next. So from here, I'll select department table. And I'll say select start from department table, and I'll click on advanced tab. I'll generate insert, update, delete. I'll say okay. What is it I'm trying to do? I'm trying to display all the records of department in my form view, and I'll say next, then I'll say finish. Now if you observe the form view here, I have got department ID, department name and HOD, and I'll click on smart tag and I'll say enable paging. I'll go on auto format and I'll select any one format. I'll say okay. I'll just enlarge it a little. Now I'll save this and let me execute. So here I get my form view. You see that I have how many departments? I have 4 departments. You can see those departments in the drop down list: development, admin, QA and QC. I can go for first page development, second page admin, third page QA and fourth page QC. Now if I want to edit any department, I can click here. I can directly edit that. I can edit the name HOD from Manzoor to Muhammad Manzoor. I'll update this. This is fine. And if I want, I can delete the record. So anyway, edit and delete we saw even in grid view. The new feature of your form view is insert option. That means if I want to insert new department, I'll click on new. Now I can create a department. Now I'll create a department 10. Name of the department as research and development R&D, and HOD is say Kareem. And I'll simply insert this. Now you see that the fifth record is R&D, HOD is Kareem. Now it is not reflected in drop down list, right? So I'll just close this and I'll re-execute this. Here I have R&D available. Now if I select R&D, actually there are no employees in the R&D, so it is not displaying any records. If I select QC, then I have few employees in QC. Now I can send, see, now let us see the ID of R&D, it is 10. Now I'll update Mark and I'll send him to R&D. I'll just update this. Now if I select R&D, you can find Mark here. See that Mark is available in R&D department. So this is my form view. It is very simple. I can simply drag, drop and configure it. What I want is, see, if I click on new button, then it is showing me a form of department ID, department name and HOD. Then I am going for insert. Now what I want is, by default, whenever I execute this, it should show me this form whenever I click a new link. To show me this form. So what is that I should do? I need to set a property of form view. So I'll select form view, hit click properties. I need to set the default mode. So I have a default mode available here. Default mode is read only. I'll change it to insert. If I change the default mode to insert and then I'll execute this. Now if you observe, it is looking like a form for me, ready to insert a department. So now directly I can write any department, department 11, department name is COE, Center of Excellence, and HOD name say Lara, and I'll simply insert this. So I have one more department available with me. Now I'll just close this and re-execute it. Now I have COE department. Now if you observe, whenever I insert a record, I need to re-execute my application to make its reflection in drop-down list. Now what I will do, whenever I click insert, automatically my drop-down list should get updated and it should have that record available in my drop-down list. So how do I do that? It is very simple. I need to go for the inserted event of my form view. I'll check the events. Item inserted event. Now once the item get inserted, this event is raised, like we have button and button click event. In the same way, form view with item inserted event. I'll double click here. Now I got the event. I can simply say drop down list 1 dot data bind. It is going to update the drop down list with new data. Now I'll execute this. Now I'll create a new department with department ID 14. Department name say PDG and HOD say Mala. Now if I click on insert, this PDG department should get updated directly in my drop down list. Now currently you see there is no PDG department. Now I'll click on insert. Now I'll check my drop down list. You can find PDG available here. But if you observe, my old data is getting appended in my new data. So what is that I need to do? I need to write a single line of code for that. So what is that I'll do? I'll just close this. I'll go to the form view one insert item. Before data binding, I'll clear the drop down list, then I'll rebind the data. So how do I clear drop down list one dot items dot clear? So it is going to remove all the items, then it is going to bind the new data. So I'll execute this. See, once say I have a department DSS and say HOD is skill. I'll insert this. If I insert this, now I check the drop down list. I got DSS and no data repetition. So this is very simple. I can work with form view. Now what I want is, I'm going to cascade my grid view with my form view. I want to cascade my grid view with my form view. So how do I do that? Instead of me displaying the records of department in form view, I'll display the records of employee. So I need to configure the data source. I'll say the same data source. I'll just say next. Instead of displaying all the departments, I'll say display employees, so that I can perform insert operation on employees table. So select star from employee table. I'll click on advance, next, finish. Say yes. Now this time I don't want to enable paging. I'll just remove paging and let the default view be read only. Now what I will do, whenever I select any record in the grid view, it should show me that record in my form view. That means, like whenever I select a department, it is showing all the employees of that department. In the same way, whenever I select any particular employee, it should display me the record of that particular employee, so that I can perform edit, delete or new operation on my employee table. So what is that I'll do? I'll not perform edit and delete operations over here. I'll perform edit and delete operations over here. And here I'll not show the complete information about the employee. If I want the complete information, I'll select that employee and I'll display the information here. So what is it I'll do? From here, I'll just remove employee salary, date of birth, employee gender and department ID columns. So how do I remove that? Edit columns. And here I have all the columns. I'll be simply removing my department ID column, employee gender column, date of birth, employee salary. I'll have only employee ID and employee name. I'll say okay. And even editing and deleting I'm not going to perform here. So I'll remove editing and deleting. So I'm going to perform editing and deleting in my form view. Now what is it I should do? Whenever I select a record, that record should be popped in my form view. So I need to again configure this. I'll say configure data source. I'll say next. Now I'll say display me the record of an employee where employee ID equals to, get the value from a control. The control is my grid view. I'll say add. I'll say okay. I'll say next. I'll say finish. So that's it. Now I'll just save this and let me execute. So whenever I select a department all the employees of that particular department will get popped into my grid view. Now, whenever I select an employee, the details about that employee will be popped into my form view. So I have cascaded. I have cascaded form view with grid view and grid view with drop down list. So let us see that. Now I'll select a department, records. Now I got the records of all the employees of that department. Now I'll select an employee. Now this is the form view. It displays all the information of that employee. Now if I want, I can edit this. If I want, I can delete this record. Or if I want, I can insert a new record. I can say new employee. Employee ID 121. Employee salary 8000. Date of birth 12/12/2000. And employee gender, say male. Okay, sorry, this is not an employee ID, it is an employee name. Employee ID is auto increment column, so it is not showing us employee ID. So employee name, I'll just write Farooq. And department ID, say 4. Now I'll insert this. So one record should get inserted in department 4. Farooq is available with us in QC department. If I select this, it should display me the Farooq record. So what is it I have done? If I select a department, it should display me the records of that department. If I select an employee, it should display me the details about that employee. I can edit, I can delete, or I can have a new record of an employee. So this is how I can cascade my drop down list with grid view and grid view with form view. So this is all about your form view. Thank you very much.